Why be shomer negiah?
You know, there's a yid whose name is Rabbi Gavriel Tziner. Rabbi Gavriel Tziner lives in Borough Park. He was a chassid of the puppet Rebbe, who must have been, besides being a goy ben nidid, a big lam, a big goy. And when his Rebbe passed away, he became a Lubavitcher. And he had a correspondence with the Rebbe in the Memes in the later years. He's a very special yid. He's prolific, written many, many svarim halacha, which are really accepted in all communities of Jews. And he asked the Rebbe why Chabad doesn't do a mitzvah tanz, which is an old tradition. By a wedding, the mitzvah tanz, and I mean, I don't know the side of mitzvah tanz, it's a inapi kabbalah. They say that when our Rebbe got married, Rebbe Levik, who was a makul, made a mitzvah tanz. There's an inyan pnimi, it's an inyan from Seidah Teira. So in the Chassidic world, a mitzvah tanz is a big deal, right? The chassan dances with the kala, the father of the chassan dances with the kala, and so on and so forth. So the Rebbe's answer to him was, the question is why you do mitzvah tanz. He asked the Rebbe why Chabad doesn't, and he said, how do you do mitzvah tanz? That was the exchange, as far as I understand it. And if I'm wrong, I'm sure someone will correct me. What was the Rebbe telling him? Sure, a mitzvah tanz is a great zach. If you live in a world of mitzvahs. When you live in a world of yetzer hara, you can't afford it. You know, Reb Levik made a mitzvah tanz, and the Rebbe knew that his father made a mitzvah tanz, and he didn't object. I mean, not that the Rebbe was the kind of man who would have objected to what his father did. Reb Levik was a tzaddik, and he made a mitzvah tanz the way tzaddikim make mitzvah tanz, and the other way we make mitzvah tanz, the whole mitzvah tanz is an aveda. Pardon my candor. Let me put it to you from a different angle, yeah? The Rebbe Rashab discusses in Kuntus Avoida, Shmiras Einayim, watching your eyes. A person sees something you're not supposed to see. He gets very excited, yeah? The Gemara says, Tei sarsura dachata inun, there are two arbiters of sin. Ha'ayin raya v'alev chaymed, the eye sees and the heart lusts. So the Rebbe Rashab creates a question. He says there are people who claim they can look at immodestly dressed women and they don't get aroused, they don't get excited. So maybe people that when they see somebody who's dressed inappropriately get excited shouldn't look where they're not supposed to. But people who are indifferent to it, so why? What's so terrible if they're going to look where they're not supposed to? So the Rebbe Rashab says, why do you think a person could look at something which is inappropriate and not get excited? The answer is because he's seen it so many times. And when he saw it the first time, he did get excited. And when he saw it the second time, it did excite him in a way which is not appropriate for a person, a yid, who's supposed to have machshavas teheiris and so on. So what are you going to say? If a person is so deeply steeped in hepecha tznias, in a lack of tznias, that images that would be a challenge to a finer person are now a challenge to him because he's so deeply steeped in it, is a lot of look. That's how this works. If you're immune, if your senses are dull to inappropriate images, so you're allowed to look at inappropriate images, you're excited? No. You have to purify yourself, that you should at least be excited by it, and then you're not supposed to look. The point is that, you know, there is a phenomena in Yiddishkeit called tahara. And I tell this to people a lot. You cannot fight the challenges of our generation with a negative motivation. You can't say, you're not allowed to do this because it's an aveda. You're not allowed to do this because it's going to bring to an aveda. Because the nesayinus are too strong. The only way there's even a possibility for a bocher or for a younger man and so on to win the challenges of our times is if he has a positive wish. I want to be pure. I want to be pure in thought, I want to be pure in speech, I want to be pure in action. And if you want to be pure, you can't look at whatever you want to look at and so on. And when the person says, I'm indifferent to it, that's not the symptom of being a tzaddik, that's a symptom of being very, very deeply engrossed. And that's not a heted, that's not a justification. You know, people say, I watch movies all the time, it doesn't give me bad thoughts. Of course it's giving you bad thoughts because you've seen this 1,000 times. The first time you thought it was inappropriate. And the same is true when it comes to shomer negiah. Touch is a real powerful thing. Yeah, touch. The fingers have incredible sensory responses. You know, people can touch very, very softly, have an incredible effect on another person. But not everybody's so sensitive. Some people you touch and they're very sensitive. People touch are not so sensitive. And the question becomes, what's so terrible if I touch somebody from the opposite gender? It doesn't have that great effect on me. It's the same issue. When a person is pure in his actions, and he touches somebody from the opposite gender, it creates an incredible response. But if a person has so been involved in this kind of a behavior that he's no longer sensitive to it, he says, what's the big deal, shomer negiah? And the answer to the question is, how did he reach this point? How did shomer negiah become an issue which is a non-issue? And this is how this question is understood in Chassidus. You know, Ove v'shana nasa like a heter is not a heter. That I can look at inappropriate imagery, it's not going to create a certain reaction in me. That I could touch a woman, it's not going to create an inappropriate reaction in me because my senses are dulled, because I'm so deeply immersed. That's a reason to purify oneself more. Not to say, for me, it's not an issue. And this is the sad reality of this question. The correct answer to the question, why is it such a big deal to be shomer negiah? And the answer is because there are people who reached a point where they can ask this question. The insensitivity, the dulling of our senses from being so overexposed. And I understand, I mean, you know, there's all kinds of yidden. Yeah, if a yid is not a shomer Torah mitzvah, a yid is not frum, and he chooses to keep taras ha-mishpacha, so for him, there's a different standard. We're talking about a frumah yid, talking about a chassid. And the definition of a chassid is the flim yishoros adim, not looking to cut corners. The idea that a person can say, I watch movies and they don't create these feelings in me, is a symptom of having watched movies. And the first movie did create that response, and it's not supposed to be there. And the being immune to it, not feeling it, is a deeper involvement, not a lesser involvement with it. And the same is true with touch.